An EV adventure through 14 countries and 3 continents.
This guy, Rich Jamiro, explains in today's Tech Smart. It's a lot of travel.
That is a lot of travel. 10 months in a road trip. That is a long time. And as a married couple. And I'm happy to report they are still together.
Okay.
I did check that. No, I asked. I said,
no, that's funny. I mean, serious. It says a lot. Of, those of us who are married know it says a lot about it.
Yeah. So imagine a road trip so epic it takes you 20,000 miles through 14 countries, and imagine doing it in an electric vehicle. One couple was up for the challenge, and recently I met up with them to talk about their trip.
This is the car that Chris and Julie Ramsey drove from one end of the earth to the other.
We had a lot of heated debates, didn't we?
Yeah. The married adventure couple chose an EV as a way to prove the technology is capable of the grueling 20,000-mile drive in various conditions.
We were about 220 miles into the Arctic Ocean, so we were driving on the ocean, and that has loads of complications, loads of challenges.
Nissan brought me to the Chicago Auto Show where I met up with the couple, who used a Nissan Ariya electric SUV with modifications like these giant 39-inch tires, a skid plate to protect the battery, and an espresso machine in the trunk.
Because I like my coffee. Keeps me awake in the morning.
The 10-month journey took the couple through 14 countries and 3 continents, driving about 130 miles a day.
It shows just how capable EVs are.
The couple charged the EV in various ways, saying it was easiest to find public chargers in North America. But as they made their way south, things got trickier. In South America, an advanced team installed chargers along the route that were left there.
That's a CCS connection there.
They also plugged in with the help of strangers. In the Arctic, they were forced to use a generator, but used wind and solar to offset some of the fuel they needed.
There was zero breakdowns. So the takeaway is just learning for us and confirmation to us that EVs are robust, EVs are reliable, EVs charge in the hot, in the cold, and in the toughest terrains.
We've heard from so many people that they've said, I've watched your trip and I want to go EV. Or you've changed my opinion or perceptions of EVs. Or I'm going to think a little bit differently now about sustainability. That is the most exciting thing and the coolest thing for me, I think.
The couple said they passed the time mostly by talking to each other and replying to followers on social media and, of course, planning the next leg of their trip. As for the best food they had, for her, it was barbecue in Chile. For him, it was mole in Mexico. All right, if you want to learn more about their trip, you can go to my website. It is richontech.tv. Certainly an epic adventure.
Yeah.
You really get to know someone, even
right,
in a short road trip. But that's
they're like travel influencers. This is kind of what they do, right?
Yeah, I think he runs a company where he does like EV adventures for people. Like that's his job.
Very cool.
So kind of a cool thing to do. And 10 months, you know?
Yeah.
On the road?
That's so much. That's just a lot.
You guys.
That's just a lot.
A lot of espresso.
It is not us. They would be sick of us. Our spouses would be like, can we go back early?
Well, they said they planned on listening to like podcasts and stuff the whole time. They ended up just chatting. So
they like each other.
Yeah.
Well, it's also new in the relationship.
And we only hear the good things.
That's true.
So, all right, we're going to talk about our weather. Thank you, Rich. Happy Monday to you. And as we celebrate Megan's birthday today.
Yeah.
We haven't heard.
Oh, happy birthday.
Thank you.
So, President's Day.
Yeah. We brought in a little rain. Megan loves the rain. She likes to go for hikes. We all know that. She